The Zacks Rank, Value, Momentum, Growth, and Income all factor into Zacks Rank Buys.
A couple of growth and income stocks is what we're talking about here with our growth and income stock strategist, Todd Bunton. I see you're back on the REIT bandwagon again.
I know, huh? I can't get away from them.
I'm telling you. Well, you were for a while.
Yeah, well, last year, you know, rising interest rates, a lot of these got crushed, but yeah. With the 10-year trading down, a lot of them look attractive.
Well, the one you've brought to us to talk about here is Hersha Hospitality Trust, a real estate investment trust with upscale hotels in their portfolio.
That's right, yeah, and the hotel industry has been hot across the board. I mean, it's not just Hersha. We've seen increases in room rates and occupancy rates across the board. Mm-hmm. And if you think about a hotel, you know, a lot of fixed expenses. So when you do get that top line growth, the operating margins explode, and that's what we've seen with Hersha Hospitality. Like you said, they're focused on the upscale market. They have 51 hotels in key gateway cities on the East Coast, some West Coast penetration as well. But yeah, they're in cities like New York, Boston, Philly. They're in D.C. and Miami. Like I said, the high scale or the upscale market there. They've enjoyed the nice industry tailwinds this year as well. So that was on display in the third quarter. They delivered a very solid earnings beat that was driven by the rising room rates, rising occupancy rates, and expanding profit margins. And management also increased its full year guidance, which prompted analysts to raise their estimates higher, not only for 2014, but for 2015 as well. This is a trend they expect to continue throughout next year.
Cool.
And if you take a look at the price and consensus chart, you can see a nice upward trend in consensus estimates really all year long. This has been a trend we've seen in the hotel space. And it sent the stock to a Zacks rank of 2, which is a buy rating. So very good earnings momentum here and good growth. If you look at the expected earnings growth here, analysts are looking at about 18% earnings growth this year, 16% growth next year. And on top of that, you know, as a REIT, they pay a good dividend. They pay dividend yields 3.7%.
That's good.
Yeah, so you're getting great income to go along with the good growth here. The company recently increased its dividend by 17%, so good momentum on that front as well. And all at a pretty reasonable price. They trade at about 13 times forward earnings. That's actually below the industry median of 17 times. On an economic value to EBITDA multiple, they're trading about 18 times. That's in line with the industry median. So, you know, there's no reason this trend can't continue over the next few months. Obviously, you know, if you think of, you know, the hotel industry, it's heavily tied to the economy. So an improving labor market, improving economy means good things for these guys.
What's that spot to get circled over there?
That's just the consensus estimates for both 2014 and 2015.
Oh,
so
okay.
I wanted to highlight those. Those are on the right side of the chart. And yeah, just nice steady upward trend. That's what we like to see here at Zacks.
I like that 3.7 dividend. That's
yeah,
what I like.
That's pretty nice.
S&T Bancorp, STBA, a financial holding company in Indiana.
Well, it's Indiana, Pennsylvania, which is always confusing. Yeah. So there's actually an Indiana University.
It confused me.
Of Pennsylvania. Yeah. I went to Indiana University in Bloomington myself, and I'm always like, there's an Indiana in
Pennsylvania?
But yeah, but that's where they're headquartered, and most of their branches are there. They have 56 branches in western Pennsylvania and some in Ohio as well. But S&T Bank, for people out there, they would know them as S&T Bank.
Okay.
Primarily focused on the commercial side of the business. About three-fourths of their loan portfolio comes from commercial real estate, commercial and industrial loans, and construction loans. So heavily focused there. They do have some residential mortgages, some home equity lines, but really they're a commercial bank, and very solid metrics. The credit quality is just excellent over the last couple of years from this bank, and the company delivered very solid results on October 30th, saw solid loan growth. Like I said, excellent credit quality and an improving efficiency ratio as they keep an eye on those non-interest expenses. So a lot going right for this bank. And if you look, consensus estimates have steadily moved higher for several months now. I also circled the 2014 and 2015 consensus. You can see a nice stair-step pattern in consensus estimates as the company will beat one quarter, and analysts raise their estimates. They beat the next quarter, analysts raise those estimates even higher. Mm-hmm. And you can see what that's done to the stock price. It's trading at, you know, multi-year highs here. But still some reasonable valuation too, which I'll get to in a second. But if you look at consensus estimates, analysts are expecting about 15% earnings growth from this company this year, 8% growth next year. It's a Zacks rank of 1, which is a strong buy rating based on the earnings momentum you see here. On the dividend side, they pay a dividend that yields 2.5%. They recently increased that by 6%. So some decent income to go along with the good growth here. And like I said, you know, even though it's trading at multi-year highs, the valuation still looks reasonable. They traded just 14 times forward earnings and 2.0 times tangible book value. The reason I say that that's reasonable valuation is if you look at their 10-year median, that's right in line with that. So, you know, 14 times and 2 times tangible book is what they've, you know, the median they've traded at over the last 10 years. So there's a lot to like about this bank.
All right. Do you own either of these?
I do not.
Check out more stock picks and stock picking strategies and stock commentary as well. It's all on our website, Zacks.com. So if you're not there already watching this video, get on over. It's highlighted on the homepage, and you can link to those articles and stock picks right from there. With Todd, I'm Terry Ruffalo.